The few points we need to discuss today: this is the present tax structure, taxation system. Then why GST? What is GST? What is the benefit of GST? And GST area of impacted in SAP, and then GST returns, and finally GST Subidha provider. This is GSP. Okay, first of all, now if you see the present tax structure in India, basically in our tax structure we have divided in the main two portion. One is direct tax, another is the indirect taxation. In direct taxation, one is income tax, another is wealth tax, and indirect tax there is central tax, and central tax this is excise, service tax and customs. And if you're talking sales tax, then VAT and local tax, and some area they are using octroi also tax portion. Okay, this is the current structure, current tax structure in India. Now what is the sales tax? When you see the sales tax structure, the sales tax at the, if you see in the screen, now what is the difficulties in why Indian government moved to GST? What is the main purpose of GST? If you see this screen, the basically when you purchase something from some manufacturer, then again you have to buy some sales tax, again you have to, when retailer is buy, then again tax is collecting from this person, again hand over to any other person, then again tax is generated. So what is the problem of sales tax? This is multiple tax on tax. The main concept is calculation tax on tax every time. Okay, and finally the product cost is day to day increasing, the main concept. Now the same concept of this VAT and CST and everything. Then also input credit system is also not clear. This is totally depend on you, as per your booking input and output. Just this is not clear also. What is the input and output? This is the input credit system is also not clear. Okay, now government come up with a single solution. This is called GST. What is GST? This is goods service tax. Goods and service tax is comprehensive tax levy on manufacturing, sales and consumption of goods and service at national level. GST tax on goods and service will value added at each stage of having comprehensive and continuous chain of set of benefits from the producer and service providers. Point to the retailers, okay, to should be bear the tax. GST is uniform tax code that bring together most of the tax that are currently imposes of goods and services under a single banner. Okay, this is the context of the current system with a multiple tax being levied separately on goods and service. GST is expected to ring the following advantages among many others. Okay, then what is the need of GST? Introduction, the main why India need GST. This is the purpose. GST is introduced majorly due to two reasons. The current indirect tax structure is full of uncertain due to multiple tax and multiple rates. First, okay, introduction of GST to replace the existing multiple structure of central and state tax is not only desirable but imperative in the economy environment. Okay, sorry. Next is, due to multiple tax rate, there are multiple forms and there are inter compliances. This will improve the tax compliances. This is the main purpose of the GST. Basically, if you think, what is GST? Goods and service tax is comprehensive indirect tax on manufacturer sales and comprehensive of goods and services throughout India to replace several indirect tax levied by the central and state governments. GST is encompassed based on the tax that will pay to the state where goods are finally consumed. Okay, the GST main logic or main concept on supply based taxation, the main concept of supply based taxation. GST will be implemented in dual mode, central GST, CGST to be collected by the central, replacing the excise duty and service tax, and state's GST, SGST to be collected by state, replacing VAT, entry tax, OCTRA and other sales tax. But remember one thing, MCD or any other tax remain continue. An interstate transaction to attract the integrated GST, okay, IGST, which is proposed to the double rate of CGST, that is addition of CGST and SGST. The goods and service tax is single indirect tax levy on goods and services. It is a normal, this is tax based consumption tax. This is all the previous tax. Some product also, if you're talking about any other, I think cigarette or alcohol, they are again excise duty, they are collecting excise duty, and apart from that, they are also calculate GST also. But if you're talking about service tax, CVAT, SAD, CST, CVD, all no more available. See, now if you're talking about CGST, move to excise duty and service tax. If you're talking about SGST, this is VAT, entry tax, luxury tax, purchase tax, OCTRA, okay, and then CGST, CVD move to IGST. This is the normal framework of the GST. See, I'll give you one example. See, now the sale price before GST, this is the sale price is 100. Okay, after GST, the sale price is 100 plus 10, this is 110. Then GST total is 10. If you're talking input credit, this is also 0. Now GST payable is 10. Again, the manufacturer is 160, manufacturing sales price is 160 plus 10% GST assumption. Okay, then 176. Now total GST is 16, input credit is 10. This is bring from in supplier 10 and GST payable is 6. Again, wholesaler, this is 200. The total tax rate is 20 GST. The total pay is 20, input is 16, 4 is GST payable. Now in every level, every place, they are, before this is not possible, they are claiming the input credit. They are also claim the input credit. Okay, in every step, retailer and consumer, finally, who will pay this tax? Finally, this is pay the consumer. Finally, consumer will pay the GST. Okay, the what is input tax credit? This is called ITC, input tax credit, means GST charge on any supply of goods or services which are used or intend to be used in a course of the business and include the tax. Okay, this is the basically GST. If you see this picture, this is manufacturing, they claim back GST, again wholesaler, they came back GST, and retailer, again they came back GST, and finally consumer will pay the GST. This is the whole concept. See, what is the benefit out of this? Now if you not claim this GST, then your price will be increasing. This is the plan, ki when you claim it, then you should reduce your price. Then finally, if you see this my example in this screen, the cost of product is 275. If you receive this, maybe this cost is near about 200 is the cost. This is the whole assumption. Okay, and how to avail input credit availment? IGST you can adjust through IGST, CGST and SGST. CGST adjust CGST and IGST, and SGST also you can adjust SGST with IGST. But remember one thing, SGST and CGST or vice versa said not allowed when you want to avail the credit. This is the benefit which I talking earlier. Okay, now what is the GSTN number? What is the GSTN? What is the GSTN? GSTN is goods and service tax identification number. This is basically 16 digit number. 2 digit is the state, next 10 digit is PAN, 13 digit is the numeric, 14 digit is JED, and 15 digit correct number. This is the GSTN number total. Now come to the SAP. What is the GST impacted area in SAP? Remember one thing, as per prerequisite note, as per SAP prerequisite note number 1175384, two prerequisite is there. First, you have to update your service pack level. Your system should be ECC and your service pack level as per enhancement package. If you are using base ECC, then you have to upgrade your SP level up to 26. SP 26. If you are using HP2, then SP is 16. If you are using HP5, then your service pack is 13. Like that. And next prerequisite is your tax procedure should be tax INN. Your tax procedure should be tax INN. Apart from that, if you're talking about SAP, the impacted area is tax registration number. The one is master data. I'll discuss details in this. Master data, see, impacted area, tax registration, master data maintenance, tax configuration and consumption, document numbering, business process localization, GST's tax postings, okay, utilization and reporting. Tax registration number, first you have to update tax registration number. After SAP given so many notes nowadays, they are also releasing wave 2 notes also. Before that, they are releasing as per draft law, they are releasing some notes. Okay, after they are releasing wave 1 and now they are also releasing the note number wave 2 also. First, you have to after apply this patch in system, then your GST number field should be populated. And before SAP, when GST discussion is going on, SAP strictly mentioned they are not introducing any GA table. They are introducing only standard table and also update the data in the standard table. They are not using any J table. At the time of their scene, they are using J table. Now they are not using any J table. Okay. For CGST, SGST and IGST, single registration is required. Okay. And this GSTN number, this GSTN registration number should be populated in business place area. This is BUPLA. Next, this is master data maintenance. If you're talking about master data, in master data tax number 3 field in customer and vendor, you have to update tax registration number. When you implemented tax in your scene tab, in vendor master or customer master, one additional field is updated. This is GST and you have to update some data as per GST. Okay. Apart from that, you have to tax configuration and computation is, I mean to say this is tax procedure, pricing procedure, you have to change as per SAP. Then if you want, after that master data maintenance, you have to update your tax configuration and computation. You have to create certain condition type, certain access sequence, certain rule you have to define. After that, using certain with key parameters, with a certain key parameters, you have defined the all those, tax condition from what basis you want to calculate this tax. This is mentioned in note number 2407890. Okay, first you have to activate the field catalog. Okay, this is a totally configuration portion. See, some configuration point of view, there are changes. Tax basically calculated on the country, region of the delivery pan, tax classification, region and control code. After that, SAP is also introduced for document numbering for outgoing invoice numbering. Okay, then business place localization. You have to update business place wise GL account. In one state, if you are using a multiple business, you have a hospitality, you have a FMCG, any other also, then in a state, you have only one GSTN number. One GSTN registration number, not multiple registration number. Okay, and after that, totally derived from the GL accounts and all this, this is business place wise. And for intrastate transaction, we are using CGST and SGST applicable, or interstate or import transaction, IGST is used, or export transaction, this is zero rate. Also, we have to update your, we have to create certain new tax condition, access sequence also, and also this is upgraded on the SD pricing procedure, FI pricing procedure, MM pricing procedure, you have to update. And at the type of the condition type, you have to key combination, you have to maintain the tax rate, and system automatic derive the tax rate from this place. Also, if you're talking about the master data, then you have to define the document numbering also, maintain document class wise. You have to, you are able to maintain the document class wise document number. Like you are using RE document type, WA document type, WE document type, like that document type wise, you are able to maintain the number range. Then again, assign number ranges to business place also. Now the broad level changes in this process localization, if you business process localization, if you are talking the sales process, the procurement process, stock transfer process, subcontracting process, also standard FI process, every process is impacted. Those are impacted on GST. Okay, now finally, this is the utilization of the report. How do you utilize your credit? How do you input credit you are utilized, and how to update your all the details in the GSTN portal? And finally is the reporting. Some company, they are using in a YT code or GT code. They need to modify your existing program as per new, or otherwise you have to create the new program as per your requirement. Okay, again, utilization, I have already discussed utilization, input credit, how do you utilize input CGST to be utilized against CGST and IGST, and input SGST will be utilized against output SGST and IGST. Input IGST will be utilized against output IGST and CGST and SGST in order to IGST, CGST and SGST. Maybe for utilization purpose, SAP may be given some standard T code for all the customers, like J2IUN. Now today we are using J2IUN, same screen maybe they are given for the utilization purpose. And also some tax reporting purpose, they are given some tax registration like CGST register, IGST register and SGST register also. Okay. Now, if you're talking about the return overview, this is the what is the return and what is the return and which type of the return you are update. Okay, what is the requirement and how do you update all those things, when you have to update, what is the prerequisite, how do you reconcile in your portal. Okay. How to work GSTN system in the portal. Okay, a return statement is specific which is the business activity undertaking the taxable person during who will pay the this is the who will pay the tax and all those, you can find this screen also. Whether different return under CGST, SGST, no, there is be a common e-return for CGST, IGST and SGST. Okay, no need to separate this. When you will be return, the final return, outward return supply on 10th, inward supplies on 15th, monthly details of outward supply by 17th, okay, and monthly return by 20th of the following month, annual return will be 31st December of the following year. See, I'll tell you what is the GST. GSTN is GSTN goods and supply tax network. GSTN is a section of 25 non-government, okay, private limited company to set up a preliminary of the provide to IT infrastructure. This is basically I'm talking about this this GSTN portal and the ASP, GSP and all those. I'm talking regarding this thing only. Then after that, based on your GSTN number, you have to log in your system with certain key parameter or access sequence. You have updated your all details in terms of purchase, in terms of sales, you have to upload in the GSTN portal. After that, after any debit note or credit note, now before what you have done, if you receive 10 quantity material from customer, if any one or two quantity is rejected, then you straight away just received only 10, only eight quantity. Example is 2 is rejected, then you have received only 8 quantity. But now this is not possible. You have to receive 10 quantity, and after that you have to raise debit credit note on 2 quantities. This is the standard practice. And one more thing, there is no, you have to individual line item wise, you have to calculate the tax. Summarization is not possible. For individual document, you have to tag individual tax. If it come through your pure route or normal FI route, you have to, there is no summarization. In a single vendor, if you have a multiple purchase order, then you don't have any option. Even this is not acceptable. Don't summarize these 10 documents. Just create individual one by one. Summarization concept is gone. One by one, you have to calculate the tax. Okay, now in same screen, if you see in the standard screen, and there is main concept of the place of supply, the total tax derived from supply based taxation. At the time of PO, if you assume this delivery received from X location, now at the time of Myro, when you received the bill, then you think the location X not, location should be Y. Then at the time of the MIRO or Myro goods received invoice, at the time of invoicing, just you change the location. On the basis of this location, system derive the taxation. Okay, the total concept of supply based on taxation. This is not the straight away tax, totally depend on the supply, so place of supply. This is supply based taxation. Now, who is required to file? Everyone registered person except everyone. If you are taxable or not taxable, then you have to also submit your GST. Every registered person except input service distributor, non-residential taxable person, okay, and person deduct TDS or collection of TCS. Rest of the all people who is registered in, this is the mandatory, you have to register in GSTN. GSTN, you have to take the GST registration number, otherwise you are not able to deal in the current market. Now, if this is mismatch, after uploading GST 1 and GST 2, what if this is anything is mismatch, then how to supplier who is furnished GST 1 remain unmatched due to error or submission should rectify the details in return file for the month of which error is omission found and pay the tax totally. See, before that, what we are doing, as per our calculation, this is input and this is output. On the basis of input output, we are taking the able the credit, but this is not possible. From move forward, you are not able to claim the credit in this manner. After your when you upload, this is also HSN. The certain key parameter is there, GSTN number, HSN, SSC number is there. Then on the basis of this invoice number, okay, on the basis of this, system automatically match, okay, with the all the details and invoice wise. After matching the whole details, you are only able to claim the credit, not before that. Now SAP come up with their Fiori app solution, S4HANA solution, okay, when you upload this GSTN portal, they are come up with new solution, okay. Through Fiori app, you have to upload the all details and match on the system itself, or if it is possible, then you download it and match it, and then again you re-upload it. Obviously, SAP is given certain time period to again rectify this thing, and finally you are able to receive this. This is the return type, GSTR 1, GSTR 2, GSTR 3, like 4. The GSTR 1 is outward supply, okay, 10th due date, 10th of the next month. If you are GSTR 2, inward supply received by the taxpayer other than computing taxpayer in ISD. This is 15th of the month, okay, monthly return is 20th of the next month. GSTR 4 is quarter return for the compounding tax pay, and then periodic 5, like that 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, also annual return, final return, everything is there. They are given the type of the return, 1 to 12, I think they are given. Okay, now what is GST Subidha provider? What is GST Subidha provider? GST Subidha provider is GST system following the a platform. GST Subidha provider, GST system is following a platform to approach the providing service to the taxpayer. All GST system functionalities like register in the entities and uploading of invoice, filing to return will be available through APIs. Through APIs, GSTN believes to creating the services provider. You can upload through mobile apps and portal. You can update GST. Okay, you can upload all these details through GSTN. What is the functionalities availability available for GSP through API? GST system will have certain features like registration of the taxpayee at tax consultant, return GSTR1 up to GSTR12, payment, okay, and ledger maintenance facility, miscellaneous, okay. In market there are so many ASPs, ASP partner is there, like SAP is also there. Then in this case you have to upload all your data in cloud concept is there in this data synchronizing from your system to GSTN system. There is cloud concept is there and you can upload your everything is on everything is this is through possible on your encrypted format. Data privacy is there, data privacy is there, no one is able to see your data and which invoice amount and value amount, nobody is able to do it. To see the data and value, this is not possible right now. All are encrypted mode. Okay, and for tax professional, see, after what is the functionality then? Then return returns is facility is there, payment facility is there, ledger maintenance facility is there, everything is there in GST through API. And if you're talking about the registration, what is the registration facility in available? What is the registration facility? New registration, amendment for existing registration, cancellation for existing registration, and your in out functionality, revoke functionality, everything is there in GSP portal. Also, if you want, you can surrender your registration also. And in API, through API, this is return return module is there. See, now as per discussion, the 2 years is free. After that, they are charging on basis of the volume of the your transaction or invoice or not clear how they are charged, but maybe they are charging on the basis of the volume, document volume. And if you're talking about in GSP return, upload invoice to various types, B2B, B2C, etc. This is also possible. Update and upload invoices is possible, accept, reject, modify, okay, and counterparty invoice also. This is all possible in the GSP system. Okay, auto-populated GSTR2, GSTR3, GSTR4, etc. Everything is there. Also, in this screen, you can see also input tax credit ledger also and cash ledger also. You can find it out here. And payment mode, then you creation of the challan, payment history, everything is there through this API. Also, in this this API's concept, this is ledger module is there. Then utilize of the cash and ITC and tax payment, all you can see from view this GSP portal also. And other is then the total combination is HSN, SSC code, tax pay and tax consultant search. Everything is functionality there. If you want to find any document or you want to sort any document with any parameter, then this is also possible. Through search option is also there in this system. You can find. Okay, this is the taxpayer, this is the ASP and GSP. Some company they are using as ASP as GSP, and then this is also GST systems. Now if SAP, for this functionality you have to buy some product from SAP also. If this is GSP and ASP, SAP is also there, so many you have to register ASP, GSP in market. There are so many, E&Y is there, any other companies also there. Okay, so many companies is there as a working as a ASP and GSP. Okay, now SAP is also there. If you want, then you can buy the SAP I mean to say this is SAP product for SAP, GSP and SAP. For this purpose, they are given some T codes or some new T code or new some functionality for GSP and ASP purpose. This is standard. They are given some T codes and all that. They are, if you see the webinar of the SAP, then you can find all those things. And another some company they are using in ASP and GSP. Okay. Or if you want your ASP is using from SAP and not you are using GSP from this person, you can use GSP from other person. You are using, like, see, SAP is providing GSP and ASP both. Now you are interested to taking GSP only SAP. Okay, ASP, SAP and GSP from another company. Then this is also possible. Then if you want in the after 1 year, 2 year, you can revoke your contract and assign any other customer to ASP, GSP partner. Okay. Then what is the main concept? One taxpayer is there and taxpayer applicable. Then GST portal is there and GST system is there. Then GST server. Finally, GST server is there. All documents will be updated through this. This place and this place, all document in encrypted mode. You are only able to see this document, your own document. Certain validation, certain password is there, one-time password is there. Everything is there in terms of, and all details will be stored in a cloud. Okay, you have to buy some data, and SAP is providing some, they are coming with HANA and Fiori app solution also. You can, if you want, you can avail it. Okay. Now, I have prepared this thing for the GST demo session. Or if you have any question, any query, please, you can ask now.
Sir, this is Ambi Sajdeva. I have one query.
Yes.
Suppose a company has got a different place of business in different states. So in that case, in SAP, the person has to, it is essential to register in every state the different GST number, or the same GST number will come in.
No, state-wise GST number is required.
But the company is one, and it has got a place of business in different states.
And no, in see, case, oh, tell me, sorry, please.
And in case these companies, these are the sister companies. I mean, that is the main company. Suppose in Delhi, this is one is the main company. And in other states, they are having a sister companies or different branches, you can say, or different sister companies. So in that case, all will be having different GST number.
In a state-wise, you have to take the GST number. This is the main concept. In a state, you have a different business, like FMCG business, like your tobacco business, like anything, any business you have a one registration number in a state. And another state, you have to again another registration number. GST registration number required.
So in SAP, where we talk about the place of business, so you need to have a different GST number.
Yes, business place wise, first you have to define the business place, and business place wise you have to define the GST number.
Hi, this is Rajan here.
Okay.
I have one question. For the stock transfer, let's say for example I have a plant in one state and I have the branch sale in another state. Now if I want to transfer the goods from my plant to the branch, how it will work with the stock transfer?
Your voice is not clear. Can you please tell me? Can you please?
Clear now?
No, your voice is not clear right now.
Rajan, your voice is not clear. If you want, you can type your question here, we can address it, or you can make sure your voice is clear.
Okay, I am saying that, okay, let's say for example, from my plant, okay, I am transferring some good to my branches in another state, from one state to another state.
Okay.
Okay, so it's like say a stock transfer.
Yes.
Okay, how it will work in the GST?
For trucks transfer also, interstate also, this is GST is applicable. Obviously, see, interstock transfer to be taxable under GST for any type of, you, if you want to deliver anything for your interstate also, intrastate also, GST is applicable for that. But see, in interstate, there is not anything is paid, but challan is required for that.
So do I need to provide the invoice to my branch?
Yes, for interstate, yes, intrastate also you have to provide the invoice, challan. You have to provide the bill.
Okay. And I have another more question. Okay, let's say for example, at a material master level, we have to store the SNS code, right?
Okay.
Now, let's say I have one material category. If I example the product is door. Okay. Now, based on the various characteristics, I have the various material code, okay, based on the size. Okay, I have this material code for this size, I have different material code for this, but in the nature it's a door. So do I have to maintain the different material code or one single material code I have to maintain?
See, this is like before also, this is government will be provided. If your nature is this, this is standardized code, but see, this is not totally in our hand, because see, at the time of you maintaining X in your same material, I am maintaining Y, but in this case we are not able to take the credit. This is centralized number which is given by government. We have to follow this number only. If government says you have to maintain separate, then we have to maintain separate. There is no option. Or if government says no, you can maintain in a single, then we have to maintain in a single. They are providing HSN code like that. SSC code, HSN code, they are centrally given.
Okay. And for example, one vendor is supplying me the material in two different plant. Let's say one plant is Rajasthan, one plant in Punjab, and same yes. vendor is supplying me the material to work. So do I have to maintain two vendor code in my system or
No. On the base of supply, on the basis of supply, this is what depend on the, see, in your vendor is same.
Yeah.
Your place of supply is different. On the see, basically tax is derived from the supply based taxation. This is nothing else.
Okay. So so I don't need to maintain two different vendor codes. Single vendor code is required.
No need to maintain the separate vendor.
Okay. So centralized vendors concept will work.
Yes.
Okay. But in case, for example, I have a vendor, okay, which is registered in Delhi, okay. And now vendor is saying that, okay, I have the branch in Rajasthan, okay, I will give my material from my Rajasthan branch, and for another state, okay, I will give the material from my Punjab, let's say for example, Punjab branches. So how it will, so in that my vendor is same, okay. But the vendor is saying that I will supply the material from my Rajasthan branch, and from Punjab, I will supply from the Punjab branch. Okay. So how it will work? So do I have to maintain two different vendor code or same vendor code will work?
No, same vendor code. Your tax will be derived from place of supply. Tax will be derived from place of supply only. If this is, see, if this is intrastate, this is applicable intrastate. If this is other CGST, SGST is applicable. This is totally derived from place of supply.
Okay, got it.
Hi, I have one question related to the upload returns.
Yes, tell me.
Yeah, you mentioned that the returns SAP is providing ASPs on cloud based. Is there any interface is building for on premises?
As of now, they are not. See, if you see the last webinar, they are not say any on premises concept is there, because see, you now this is totally depend on the volume basis. Okay. Uh-huh. Now this is, if you talking about the infrastructure cost is very high. Now some company, I don't know what is your company, some company they are having in a day basis 1 lakh or 2 lakhs entry. Then how you can manage in a monthly basis, this is very difficult. Or also they are, if they are a service provider, GSP, NSP, this is now they are come up with cloud only, not in premises only, because due to volume, maybe later on they'll come up with on premises, maybe.
No, I'm talking about from SAP to send the returns on a monthly basis. So can we send directly from SAP on premises server like HANA on premises from SAP directly? Can we do a file returns?
As of now, last discussion, they are not giving any on premises solution. On cloud solution, they're giving on the last webinar.
Okay.
Maybe later on they'll come up with on premises solution.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Sir, there's one more question which I want to clarify. You have talked about the CGST, IGST, and SGST. This one more thing, UGST.
Yes.
There's one more tax which has been included, that is the UGST. Union Territory, like something like that. So can you tell us something about this UGST, how in SAP it will be implemented?
See, now this is very new things. Okay, this is now we are not clear to how to this work in this portion. I mean to say UGST portion, how to work. This is clear as of now, not clear completely. They have come up with SGST, CGST, IGST, and this is also not clear how to work for India territories.
Right now the many companies are starting working on the GST implementation.
No, GST so is okay. GST is okay.
In SAP, they started working on the GST implementation in SAP. But if you talk about this UGST, a new thing has come up. So how that will be
implemented? No, not new thing. Here first they are more focused on IGST, CGST, and later on they will discuss on the UGST. Okay. First you will complete your IGST, intrastate. First you have to cover, then they will discuss on. See, so many things is now silent from SAP side also. Only they are giving certain patches, certain fields, they are only applicable. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sir, will you be able to share this presentation?
I'll just check it with the other participants who else are going to join. So later, nothing to worry about, the presentations will be having enough of material to support the training, and all the sessions which you will be attending, everything is going to be recorded for your future reference. Okay. And as you asked some of the questions very rightly, there are a lot of changes still is being on the process from SAP end. Okay. Even I can see in the last week, I guess, so they have released two different modes. So still there is an evaluation, a lot of evaluation is happening in this. So a lot of companies start implementing GST because, you know, from 1st of July, they want to make sure like everything goes very smoothly. Later on, there should not be any, you know, up and down things. And there are a lot of scarcity of, you know, enough of GST experienced resources in terms of SAP who can able to cater these things. So as Satpati has already, means like he's a very senior guy, he's a delivery manager in one of the very big MNC. Okay, and he's having nearly 12 to 13 years of experience in FICO, and he's a certified FICO consultant, he's certified S/4HANA consultant, he's very knowledgeable in terms of GST implementation in other countries. But with respect to certain, you know, government policies in India, there might be certain differences which are yet to be defined from SAP end. Okay. So that's how we are going to, you know, cater the things in a very proper way. So this training is majorly to, you know, cater all aspects of GST in terms of Indian territory, Indian market, as per the Indian laws which they are released. Okay. So the training is going to be in a very efficient manner. Okay. And all the materials and the videos will be shared to you. Nothing to worry about it. Okay. So anybody else are having any questions, you can speak out.
No, I would like to say one thing to, may I know what is your name?
Amish,
I'll tell you, first of all, SAP, when they are come with the solution, they clearly mention there is no concept of direct FI entry. There is no concept of direct FI entry, initial level. this is not possible. You have to mention certain, you have to create the material code. Okay, after a lot of discussion with SAP and the customer, no. Now, if you think your total percent out of total 100%, 20 to 30% is direct FI entry, like telephone bill, like electricity bill, like that. Now, they are again come up with the new SAP note, S note or patches. And after that, at the direct FI entry also, you are able to tag HSN SSE code and all those things. Maybe they are come up with new solution. I mean to say new patches and all those, then we are trace it out. Okay.
Hello. Hello.
Yes.
I have one question. Let's say for example, there is a one sale order from the customer before GST implementation date, means before 1st July. Okay. And customer return my material after 1st July.
Okay.
Hello. Then yeah, how yeah, tell to me. Handle that scenario?
See, wait. This is also, this portion also not clear. Before GST, maybe they will giving some 6 months or 1 year time or 4 months or 3 months time to adjust those old documents. Okay. Now you sell the material in the last of June. Okay. Now again, they will return this product. Okay. In month of December, then how do you handle? This is also not clear. The old debit credit memo and return also how to handle, this is also not clear. Maybe they are at the final level, final law is when they are coming with the proper solution, then they will just release key. How do you handle these old documents?
Okay, so before the cutover, we have to close our all open POs or that also, is there is any guideline from the SAP how to handle the open PO?
See, obviously they are giving some cutoff guideline and all those things. As of now, this is no. There is no given any cutoff, given any cutoff methodology or any guidance.
Means okay. So open item is not clear. Means how to handle the open item on the day one cutoff.
This is also not clear. This is also not received anything from the SAP point, SAP side also.
Okay.
I want to add here something, Rajan. So as you're saying, like the development is happening so fast from SAP. Maybe you can't say, maybe like in means on Monday or Tuesday, they can come up with certain solutions. So still the team is very working in SAP labs and they are finding very closely working out on these points actually. Okay. So very fastly they are coming up with the solutions and whichever the solutions are coming rightly. So everything is going to be included in the course here. So you're not going to skip any single thing.
Okay, fine.
Anyone else are having any queries? Please speak out, guys.
Hi, Raj here. I have one more query related to the vendor master. So if the vendor has multiple GSTN number, like each state he has multiple GSTN number. So is there any provision where we can link with the business place within a vendor with link with the business place and GSTN number? But how is there any facility SAP is providing where within the same vendor where he has multiple GST number we can add? If you see current VAT number, we can maintain only one VAT number. We cannot have multiple. So coming to GSTN, how we can maintain multiple GST number?
Now, as of now, same things. They are no. There is no concept of the multiple GSTN number concept is there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So still, because I have like there, we are coming up with a business place where we will be using business place linked to the vendor and provide a GSTN by business place.
In your organization, if 50,000 vendor is there, then this is not possible also.
Yeah.
This is also not possible. No, as of now, there is no concept to link the vendor and all this GST number.
So if they have multiple GSTN, then you need to create multiple vendors.
No need multiple vendors. Why? This is your place of supply. See, I have one centralized contract. Okay, like IBM, I have take the centralized agreement to implement GST. Okay, and this IBM is located at NCR. Okay, I'm avail this facility from any other places, not in this. I'm avail this facility in Bangalore.
Mm-hmm.
then
so that this GST number will be different,
yes.
Right?
Yes, yes.
How the reconciliation will happen?
Which one? Sorry?
Reconciliation, because see, like say for example, one vendor is registered in Karnataka with a one GST number, and same vendor is registered in Tamil Nadu with different GST number, and same vendor is supplying me in the Karnataka as well as the, in Tamil Nadu, because I have to do the reconciliation in the GSP based on the GST number, right?
Yes.
So same vendor is having two different GST numbers, so I have to maintain in SAP, right? Same vendor with two GST numbers.
No, this is totally derived from your place of supply. Place of supply, okay. And GSTN partner. This is derived from this place. In this document, when you upload in GSTN portal, then there is option is there. What is your HSN code? What is your SSC code? Okay, and GSTN partner, invoice number, everything is there. On the basis of this, you have to only avail the credit.
But so are you saying that in SAP we cannot store two different GST number for the same vendor?
As of now, no, this is not possible.
But is there any plan in future, like is there any roadmap? Because it's required going forward, definitely.
Mostly is required.
You can take it to, yeah, can you take it up this to your product team so that they can look into it?
Obviously,
yes,
I'll
sure.
check, but see, obviously I'll check with our product team also. See, I'm directly touch with SAP also. Definitely, I'll discuss this thing with SAP also, how yes. they will handle this scenario.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, Raj.
Okay.
Yeah. Anybody else? Because we can see a lot of participants are there. Nearly 26 participants are there over here. I guess like most of the questions which like mostly Rajan and Raj and Amish is asking, so is already been answered for other guys as well. So fine then, if you are having any queries, you can shoot out, or else we are going to conclude the session here. And you can connect with Harsha or someone from where you have already in touch. So from there we can take the further proceedings. Okay guys.
So going forward, going forward, will there be such kind of sessions will be there?
Yes. So Amish, I guess like your details are there with us, okay? Or what I suggest you, one of you can type your email address in chat window over here. Sometimes, you know, what happens is some of your friends might have referred to you. So you are coming from that particular source. So if you can type your emails here so that we can keep updating the things.
When could the final solution be coming?
That's a very big question mark, Sriram. Okay, because as you can see, SAP is always evaluating. So based on, is not like something waterfall model or something. It's totally based on how the solutions are responding. Based on that, they are coming up with the different solutions. So we can't say anything. So it's totally depends upon SAP. As of now, a lot of companies is already been started. We are also direct vendors to some of the companies in implementation. We are the implementation partner for GST as well for some of the companies, and we are helping them very closely to implement GST. We already have started, but after starting also the recently last week also a couple of notes come and there are certain changes are happening. So these things are keep on going. I am expecting at least 15 to 20 days. There might be some good proper solutions will be coming up. So that's what the things are, but as per the demand, like the companies already start implementing this. Yeah. So I can see a lot of people are pinging here in the chat window their email addresses. That is really going to help us to conduct this type of things in the future as well. Fine then guys. So I guess like most of the queries are already been answered. So you'll be getting an email for the feedback kind of thing. So please provide your feedback. That is really going to help you for us for the further things to go ahead. Yeah. Thank you guys. Thank you, Sapati. It's a very knowledgeable session today.
Yes,
so really appreciate your time and this one patience for this. Thank you, Sapati.
Thank you.
Hello. Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Thanks for this.
Bye.
Hello. Bye. Hello.
Hello, Yamurthy, you are asking something?
Yes, the next demo will be happen when we plan to use.
Yeah, you please type your email address in the chat window, we'll inform to you.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You can see at your right hand side the chat window. So you just type your email address, text your email address over there, okay, ping that email address. So we'll update you on that.
I typed it already.
Sorry, Murthy, your voice is very low. Yeah, I can see your email. You have already just typed it.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, Rajan. I can see your one. Chetan, thank you. Yes, please. So, you can see on our website, you can see on our website, you can directly connect to the website from there. You can see the we are basically providing a lot of update in SAP related all the modules, functional as well as technical modules. So you can even directly come to the chat over there. Always the executives will be available. You can type there your queries, or you can find the email address or the contact details. You can contact us anytime. We'll be always there to help you out.
Okay. Is there any website is available? But
yes. SAPwits.com. So you can go there. Yeah, SAPwits.com. So it's basically SAPwits.com. There you can see. Okay. Yeah, we are providing like solutioning to almost all the modules, like in terms of training, knowledge sharing, everything.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Siraj. Yeah, thank you. So fine then, guys. I guess like every one of you have shared your email addresses and all. I'm going to conclude my session here. So let's finish this one. Thank you for your time attending the session. Thank you, Chetan.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Anwar. Thank you, Sairam. I got your email. Thank you, Aleph.